Welcome to the Concept Unification installation tape. The purpose of this tape is to give you a brief overview of the installation process. This tape is meant to supplement the installation manual, not replace it. If you have any questions about measurements or placement, please refer to the manual. The first thing you need to do is to play the Rolf and Earl show tape and make sure everything is operational. Since this is a one-stage tape and plays for approximately a week while the conversion is being completed, it is necessary that Rolf and Earl are in the best working condition possible. This tape must be checked no later than the Wednesday morning prior to the Sunday of which installation will begin. This will give you a few days to correct any problems that may exist with the show. Next, you will need to make an appointment to have your Chuck E. Cheese neon sign installed. Call Gordon Townsend at Heath Sign Company 1-800-527-9495 and make an appointment for the end of the following week. He will make arrangements for someone in your area to come out and install your sign. Make sure this appointment is firm and is set up for early morning. The installation should take approximately an hour to complete. With your prep work now complete, it's time to begin the installation process. First, remove all props such as Choo Choo's tree, Billy Bob's lamp, Billy Bob's campfire, Looney Bird's can, all rocks and flowers, and destroy all of these props as they will not be used again. Next, unbolt and remove Fats's organ from center stage. This prop will be used again. Now find the main air lines that feed the characters and disconnect the quick connectors from the oilers for both center stage and stage left. Now remove all cosmetics from the characters starting with Duke. First his hat, then belt, collar, and vest, black vinyl torso, hands, gloves, cuffs, and drumsticks, holding onto the drumsticks as they will be used later, sleeves, mask, ears and ear levers, feet which need to be unbolted, and the tree bark from around the platform, making sure to remove all remaining staples. Now Choo Choo. First his mask, then take the bolts out and remove bottom half assembly. Next we will do Fats. Although this picture does not reflect it, if you have removed the organ, it will make his cosmetics easier to get off. First, do his jacket, hands, mask, leg fur, and feet. Now Beach Bear, starting with his shorts and guitar strap, upper body fur, hands, mask, leg fur, feet, and then the tree stump base. Now Mitzi, starting with her sweater, wig, dickie, mask, ears, not the ear levers, pigtail mount, hands, skirt, shoes, and leg fur. Next will be Billy Bob. First his overalls, then mask, body fur, hands, left foot and foam ankles, and then his right foot, which will need to be unbolted.
And finally, Looney Bird. Remove his mask, plume, and fiberglass skull.
If you have enough help, you may want to start on both stages at once. For the purpose of this video, we will start with stage left. First is Billy Bob. Unbolt his Mac valve quick disconnect and push up through the stage. Make sure to cover the quick disconnect with a piece of plastic or plastic bag to keep dust from getting into the air lines. If you will bag and label all parts that come off in order, it will make your life a lot easier once it is time for reassembly. Unbolt Billy Bob and remove from the stage. Now, disconnect the computer line from Billy Bob's Mac valve. Remove Billy Bob's Mac valve and hold for spare parts as it will not be used again. Follow the same procedure for Looney Bird by unbolting the Mac valve quick disconnect and pushing up through the stage, making sure to cover them with plastic. Then, unbolt the character mech and remove from stage. And finally, remove Looney's hand airlines and plug them up. Although not reflected in this picture, your character should now be off the stage. First, unplug the floor lights and remove. Next, unbolt the entire tree line and remove from stage. Now, pull off the canvas backdrop and remove all staples, making sure to leave the 2x4 header in place. Now, remove all carpet from stage left and clean the stage. Remove hinges on Billy Bob's trap door and nail shut. Cut a piece of wood large enough and cover the old fireplace hole in the stage. You can use the old clouds from center stage if you wish. Re-carpet the stage. Make sure to carpet under the curtain motor as well. Find Looney Bird's trap door and cut the carpet around the edge of the door so that it can be opened, leaving the carpet on top. Next, using the specifications found in the manual, you should find center line for stage left and install the brick wall. The mechs should not be on stage left at this point. Now, moving to center stage, remove the airlines from Choo Choo, unbolt, and remove from the stage. Now, Mitzi, unbolt the Mac valve quick disconnect and push up through the stage. Unbolt the character and remove from the stage. Disconnect the computer line from the Mac valve and remove Mitzi's Mac valve. Unbolt Fats's Mac valve quick disconnect, push up through the stage, then unbolt and remove Fats from the stage. Next is Beach Bear, and you will need three people to accomplish this. First, unbolt the bolts that connect the body half to the base. They run through the surfboard. Then lift the body half, remove the surfboard, then reconnect the body half to the base. Then unbolt the Mac valve quick disconnect and push up through the stage, unbolt character and remove from the stage. Next with Duke. Measure all placement of props on Duke's platform and remove all props. Do not remove Duke. Then remove grass from Duke's platform. And then using the airline quick disconnect, disconnect the airline that feeds the oiler on the back of Duke's platform and the computer line and push up through the stage. Next, move Duke's stage from center stage to stage left and position as shown in the diagram so that the back corner closest to center line is 12 inches from center line and the other back corner is 18.5 inches from the wall. Now, re-carpet the platform. This platform now will be Pasquale's platform. Replace all props on Pasquale's platform as per the measurements you took earlier, and using finishing nails, nail the front piece on Pasquale's platform. Now, replace the old Looney mech, which is now the camera mech, and bolt down as per the measurements in the manual. Now, back to center stage, unplug and remove all floor lights,
Unbolt and remove both tree lines. Duke's mech should be gone at this point. Now remove the sun mask, then disconnect the air lines, unbolt and remove mech from stage. Then the same for the moon, disconnect the air lines and unbolt and remove from stage. Finally the sign, unplug the power cord and computer line, then unbolt and remove the sign from stage. Next, unscrew the clouds from the ceiling of center stage and remove. Now, disconnect the air lines to the spider mech, unbolt, and remove the mech. Finally, pull canvas backdrop off the wall and remove all staples, leaving the 2x4 header in place, remove grass, and clean stage. Now, measure and mark center line for center stage. Next, measure and mark on the floor Helen's position so that you will have a reference point of where to put the trap door. Now cut a trap door 6 inches in front of where you marked for Helen as per the diagram, making sure to cut in between two studs in the floor. Next, cut two 2x4 braces for the trap door and screw into place. And then finally put a hinge on the trap door. Next, install the fiber optic curtain as per the manual. Recarpet center stage, making sure to cut the carpet around the existing trap door so that they will open, leaving the carpet on top. Next, reinstall the moon mech as per the diagram in the manual. Next, install building D, centered with center line on stage, as per the diagram in the manual, and screw to the floor. Now, building E, as per the manual, and screw to the floor. Now, building C, as per the manual, and screw to the floor. Now, reinstall the old sun mech, which is now the building mech, as per the manual, and bolt to the floor. Install the fiber optic controller on building D, which is the center building, as per the manual. Reinstall the sign as per the manual and bolt to the floor. Install the building face on the building mech. Unbolt the old sign face and install the new sign face, destroying the old sign face. Also plug power and computer line in for sign. Install building B and building F as per the manual and screw to the floor. Install all floor lights for center stage and aim according to the manual. Install the planter boxes, letters A and G, and install as per the manual. We will now start putting characters back on center stage, starting with Jasper. Position him as per the manual and bolt down. Cut a 2-inch hole behind his mech for airline, push the quick disconnect through the 2-inch hole, and put the two-piece base together according to the manual. Now Munch. Position Munch according to the measurements and bolt down. Cut a 2-inch hole behind his left foot for airlines and push the quick disconnect through the 2-inch hole. Follow the same procedure for Helen, positioning her according to the measurements and bolt down. Cut a 2-inch hole behind her left foot for airlines, push the quick disconnect through the 2-inch hole, and then put her mech valve back under stage. And finally, Munch Jr., which is the old choo-choo mech, positioned as according to the diagram and bolt down. Now the organ, position according to the measurements and bolt down. Cut a 2-inch hole behind the left leg for power and computer lines. Now moving to stage left, install the top border on Pasquale's brick wall on the 2x4 header. Next, install the individual brick seams that will complete Pasquale's wall. And finally, install the lights and aim according to the manual, and then install the floor border which will hide the lights. Now, reconnect all quick disconnects, computer lines, and air lines for both center stage and stage left. Pasquale uses the old Billy Bob computer line, and Helen will use the old Duke computer line. Next, install the wink and hook up the air lines, which will go to the old Spider air line. Now, we will start putting cosmetics back on, starting with stage left, Pasquale, starting with his pants, then shoes, mask, vest, shirt, apron, bandana, hands, and drumsticks. Install the light in the bottom of Pasquale's kick drum, and then install the new front for the kick drum. Next is the camera. First put on the square camera housing, and also there is a mouth clevis to be exchanged. Then his mask, and finally the speaker box cover for the camera. Next is Jasper. Now the first thing you want to do with Jasper is to exchange the eyes that are in Rolf for the eyes that are in Jasper, so that Jasper will have brown eyes and Chucky will have blue eyes. Now, starting with the costume, first his hands, also exchange the mouth clevis for Jasper, his mask, hat, shirt, overalls, guitar strap, and shoes. Next, exchange the old organ front for the new organ front, making sure to destroy the old organ front. Next is Munch, starting with his hands, then mask, cap, body fur, and feet. Next is Helen, starting with her hands, then mask, feather pigtails, blouse with fur sleeves, foam leg pieces and shoes, and finally skirt. And Junior Munch, which is just his mask, and round bent cover. Moving to the Rolf and Earl stage, this should be the very last night of the installation process. Prepare for this night as it will be a long one and everything should be up and operational by morning. First start with Earl, then vest, shirt, mask, bottom half fur, then feet and left hand. Although not reflected in this picture, all cosmetics should be off for Rolf and Earl. First, remove the rainbow, applause sign, rainbow curtain, symbol, and all floor lights. Next, unbolt the Mac valve quick disconnect, push up through the floor, then unbolt the character and remove. Next, remove all grass from stage right and clean. Make sure to mark center line for stage right, then paint the 2x4 header black. Now, recarpet stage right and make sure to cut around existing trap doors. Now, hang black rain curtain on 2x4 header. Attach all pieces on the backside of the star according to the manual, such as the base for the star, the back mounting bracket, and lights on the back of the star. Next, measure the placement of the star from center line according to the manual, and using the back mounting bracket, attach it to the wall. Next, measure Chucky according to the manual and bolt down. Cut a 2-inch hole behind his left leg, push the quick disconnect through the 2-inch hole, and reconnect the Mac valve quick disconnect. Next, lay the big screen TV on its back and remove the casters, then put up on stage and position according to the manual. Now, plug in all the lights for the star and the TV according to the manual. Now, remove the old right arm assembly from Rolf and attach the new right arm assembly for Chucky. It is time now to costume Chucky, starting with the hands and ears, mask and hat, cummerbund vest combination, bottom half fur with suspenders, jacket, base, and feet. Finally, install the big screen facade, which will have a bottom part and a top part, and then make sure to plug in the top light. Remove your spotlight number 7 from the spotlight bar and hold for spare parts as it will not be used again. Reposition spots 5 and 6 according to the manual. Install your helicopter light according to the manual. Now, in the control room, make sure the computer is powered down. Take off the top and replace the old EEPROM with the new 3.3 EEPROM. Hook up your video line to the big screen and hook up your computer cables between characters and gray box according to the manual. Re-aim and resize all spots for the new positions of the characters, making sure to use Mitzi's old spot for the Wink and the old spider spot for Munch Jr. Adjust the high end of the dual pressure regulator down to 70 pounds. And finally, VCR adjust the show to get correct character movements. If the Chuck E. Cheese neon sign has not yet been installed, it will need to be done at this point. The overall position and look of your stages should resemble these freeze frames.